Given the requirements that we listed in terms of what a cloud system has to incorporate, several different technologies come into play. First, we already talked about the need for virtualization. This is required in order to address this ability to provide fungible resources that can be dynamically repurposed, which application they serve, and then exactly how are they used, what are the expectations. You don't have to have the exact same CPU or the exact same type of device based on the customer's needs. Then you need some technologies to enable the dynamic provisioning and scheduling of resources, of the infrastructure resources. Certain platforms like Mesos or Yarn, Hadoop's Yarn, that serve this role. In order to address the customer's needs for scale, cloud technology need to provide abilities to process and store large amounts of data. There are a number of big data processing frameworks that are out there. Hadoop MapReduce is one, Spark is another one that is popular. Regarding the data storage layer, cloud computing platforms include things like distributed file systems. These are file systems that typically operate in some append-only mode, where you're not arbitrarily rewriting data and deleting data and modifying data. And then there are other important technology that enable the storage, access, and manipulation of data at scale. These include a number of NoSQL technologies, which are a departure of traditional relational SQL databases. The ability to store data across distributed memories as opposed to repeatedly perform disk accesses, and a number of other advancements. Cloud computing customers, they not only need to get the right amount of resources, however, they need to somehow be isolated from each other so that every one of them thinks that they own their resource lies. For that reason, cloud computing technologies need to include some kind of mechanism that enables these software-defined slices of resources, so that customers are provided with their own software-defined data center or subset of the storage that's controlled and defined by the software or the network resource, et cetera. And then also especially given the complexity of these environments, it's important for cloud computing platforms to also use certain efficient monitoring technologies in real time to process logs, to detect certain anomalies or failures, but also to provide that as a service to the users that may not just want some batch access to potentially large data, but more of a real time, more of a maybe interactive access to information that's produced by from their applications. Some of the technologies that provide this monitoring type functionality or real time log processing include Flume and CloudWatch. This is the Amazon service, or Log Insight. This is something, a product that's part of the VMware portfolio. Flume is open source, and many, many others.